Hello and welcome to the next tutorial in this series for 24-hour answers. This time we're going to be looking at the concept of pointers. Now we've touched on pointers briefly before, but suffice to say, we haven't gone into much detail. So the first thing I'd like to cover is the concept of what a pointer actually is. Now the easiest way to think of it is that a pointer, as opposed to a variable, is a reference to the location in memory, which is to say in RAM, of that variable during the running of your program. So if you create an integer and then create a pointer to that integer, that pointer will, instead of saying, say, the value 9, which you might have initialized the integer as, will point directly to the location in memory, which will have an appearance, something like 0x00, and then a hex address of some kind. Now, you don't need to worry too much about the specifics of that, but what you do need to know when writing C programs and C++ programs is how to manipulate pointers, because they're probably the most difficult but also the most rewarding part of C and C++ programming, and if you want to be in any way involved in industry programming with C and C++, this is a crucial concept to understand and learn. So let's start by looking at what happens when you don't use a pointer. And let's say we create an integer. And we set the integer to say to the value of 9. And then we want to create a method, or a function. And that function is going to double the value of my integer. So let's create void, because we don't want to return anything. So we think, we just want to double the integer. Double my int. And then down here we create the actual method. Same process. And we say my int equals my int times 2. And then up here, let's put system pause in. We call double my int. And then we're going to print the value. Now, a little test for you. You might want to think what the value at this point is when it's printed. I'll show you the answer, and the answer you'll see will be, I'm afraid, the number 9, which is here just before the press any key to continue statement. Now, the reason for this, essentially, is that when double my integer was called, we copied the value 9, and that's what came out here. So whatever this value is, this variable is here, is just temporary. Despite being named the same, we can actually drive home the point if we rename it. There's no reason why that value of A should persist beyond the scope of this method. So when we come back out here to this printf, we no longer have the doubled value. But just to prove the point, if we printed the value of A here and rerun, you'll see that at this point that we're in double my int, we do have a value of 18. Then when we come out, any changes to that variable have been lost. And as I say, the reason that these changes are lost is because this is just a copy of the variable and not the variable itself. So if we did want to persist this change, we might do something like set the value of my integer to the output along these lines and here, and then we return A. And now when we run, we do indeed get the value 18 at this printf statement. But this is rather clumsy for a number of reasons. Firstly, we don't really need to return the integer if we use a pointer. We can just have one call in, have my int become modified, and then we're more or less set. There are more complex reasons, but I don't want to go too deeply into those at this point. Suffice to say, there is a cleaner way of doing this, and that is to use pointers. So now let's consider the alternative, which is to instead use a pointer. First of all, we'll revert this function. As I said, we don't want to return the value of A. And so we can't set here the value of A, but we still want to persist the change that we make. So how do we go about using a pointer? Well, the first thing that will happen is the variable that gets passed into DoubleMind itself will need to be a pointer. If you do this, you immediately notice some problems. You can't set the value 9 to *mind. This is because what's now happened is that this is not an integer, but the point in memory, or the address of the point in memory, that this integer is stored. So if we want to set the value, we must dereference the variable by putting asterisk before it again. And now we have set the value to 9. So the next thing we want to do is we want our method here to also take the reference to the location in memory of the variable rather than a copy of the variable. When we update these, we see, of course, the error that was there briefly disappears. This is because we're now in agreement, we're passing in this reference in memory and not the value to DoubleMyInt, which here expects a reference in memory as signified by the star before the variable name. Not to be confused with the star used for multiplication. I'm sure you can see the difference in syntax between these two. So now we're saying A multiplied by 2, or A equals A multiplied by 2. Now the problem with this is that we can't double the reference in memory because it doesn't make sense. It's like doubling a street address. So what we instead want to do is take the value. We want to double the value because the value at this point will be 9. And the value itself, the pointer itself, also needs to be dereferenced so that the value in the pointer is increased. It just occurs to me, in fact, there's actually an error up here, but it's not the best way of illustrating, perhaps. If we actually make the value here equal to 9, what we instead want to do with our pointer is point at the location in memory of my value. And the reason I want to do this rather than just point at the numeric value, aside from the error I mentioned, when you get to using pointers with things like structures, or in C++ classes and objects, this kind of construction won't make much sense, because a class, object, or a structure will always be referenced by a variable name. So what we want to do is we want the location, which is the opposite of the star symbol, the and symbol, we want the location of my int val. So let's just make sure that this is absolutely clear. First of all, we declare our integer my int val, and we set it to 9. Then we create a pointer to an integer, any integer value, and we set the location that that pointer is pointing at to the location of my int val. And we do this by using the and symbol before the actual integer to get its reference. So if we have any variable, we know that we can place and before it to get its location. We also know that if we have any pointer, such as down here, we can place star before that to get the value behind that pointer. That is the key concept for you to grasp here. So please, I urge you to go over this, experiment with it, and make sure you understand the concept fully before we continue. So at this point, there remains one final step, and that is to modify the printf statement here so that we print the value stored in the pointer. If you do this, you'll essentially get a garbage value. I'll show you. Yes, build. So you get the number 4781952, which is the integer representation of the address in memory of the value. As long as you dereference it back to the value, here you go, the number 18. As a little extra point, you may wish to know what the actual pointer, which we've been talking about so much, looks like. So if we say my int value, we can create a my int pointer location and we modify here. Oops, don't need that. To point to %p tag, which is for pointer. Just run this, and you'll see there is your memory location 003BFDFC, which is a hexadecimal number, and that refers to the location in memory. Okay, so to sum up, any variable you can declare with the type, and by setting the value, we've covered this, no problem. The pointer, however, we give a type and the asterisk symbol to indicate that it is a location in memory of that type of variable. And then we set the actual value that that location in memory is pointing to by giving it the other variable with the and symbol before it to say that we want this pointer, this point in memory, to refer to this point in memory, which is the point in memory that this variable is stored. And then the only thing to remember is to correctly use asterisk when you want to manipulate the value, such as here where we're saying percent asterisk a, so that would be the 9 in our case, to be number 2, and so on. Now if you want to review this, one thing you might want to do to review previous material is modify this so the user sets the value that we extend. That will help you with some of the stuff going backwards. If you want to go forwards, perhaps try changing the type here. Use a double, or if you're feeling adventurous, a char. And what you may find, if you really want to go ahead, is that if you use an array of chars, you essentially have the basis of strings in their more refined form and in the form that you find them in languages like C++. So anyway, any questions, as always, post them below and I'll get back to you. Thank you.